Philippine factory gate prices contract in September. Now, data from the Statistics Authority show producer prices for manufacturing was down by 2.2% or by 0.2% in September, reversing the 0.6% increase in August. The Statistics Bureau attributed the contraction to slower expansion in electronic and optical products, as well as food items. The computer, electronic, and optical products industry registered a slower growth of 0.02% in September from 2.8% in August. The food production industry, meanwhile, posted a 2.1% growth in September. This was against the 2.7% increase the month before that.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. underscores the importance of the observance of the Day of the Dead. Marcos, like millions of Filipinos, visited his departed loved ones today. Katrina Domingo has that story.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and his family spent All Saints Day at the Libingan ng mga Bayani in Taguig City, where the remains of their patriarch lay rest since 2016. Aside from the president, among those who attended the mass in honor of the Marcos patriarch, Ferdinand Marcos Sr., are First Lady Liza Marcos and their son, Simon and Vincent, as well as Marcos family matriarch and former First Lady Imelda Marcos. And the president's sisters were also there, particularly Senator Aimee Marcos and Irene Marcos Araneta. The president did not grant interviews after the mass at the Hero Cemetery, but in his official Undas message this year, the president reminded the public that these holidays are meant to honor the dead, and they also come as a refreshing gift so that we can enjoy reuniting with our loved ones while also receiving much-needed nourishment for our spiritual lives. The president also reminded the public to reflect on the purpose and our unceasing need for God's guidance during the holidays that celebrate the saints' staunch devotion and the legacies of those who have gone before us. Now, Mika, Vice President Sara Duterte also released her own All Saints Day message, telling the public that the All Saints Day and the All Souls Day holidays are opportunities for the nation to reflect on their faith and ask the Almighty for the continued blessing of strength and healing as a nation. She also asked the public to pray for the country's protection against calamities, disasters, wars, and forces that may threaten our unity and cause human suffering.
Here's a check now at the situation in major cemeteries in the capital region. At the Manila Memorial Park in Parañaque, foot traffic has already exceeded 30,000 despite the bad weather. Authorities on site expect that number of the visitors today would reach 200,000. No untoward incidents have been recorded so far. At the Manila North Cemetery, around 38,000 people have so far visited the park in the morning. Police closed roads around the cemetery to enhance accessibility for the public. About 300 officers have been deployed both inside and outside the cemetery, with ambulances and fire trucks on standby. And at the Libingan ng mga Bayani in Taguig City, where former presidents, soldiers, and national artists are buried, there were 4,000 visitors as of this morning. Security measures are tight, with thorough inspections of entering vehicles and confiscation of deadly weapons and flammable materials. Playing of loud music, littering, and gambling are also not allowed. Special kiosks have been set up to assist visitors in locating the graves of their loved ones. Today, the cemetery is open from 6 in the morning to 8 p.m. During their lifetimes, Filipinos work hard to provide for their families. But taking care of one's family does not end upon death. Divina Law senior partner Danny Buni tells ANC people can take care of their loved ones even beyond the grave through estate planning. He explains it's never too early to start making arrangements.
At some point in our lives, we have to realize that, you know, we're not going to be here forever. Mm-hmm. So when we now think about what are we going to leave behind for our families, that's when we should really give serious consideration to estate planning. But as I said, even if you're single, even if you're just starting working, you can already do estate planning by way of different types of instruments. We want to leave our families behind in a good financial position. We've strived hard, we've worked hard all our lives. So taking care of our families beyond our life should be something that we should give serious consideration to, you know. And we do have laws, but we do have a wide array of doing estate planning. There are ways to give your friends, charities. So take serious consideration.
Back here at home, residents in the central Philippine province of Bulacan reject a proposal to turn San Jose del Monte into a highly urbanized city. The plebiscite was held October 30, coinciding with the Village and Youth Council polls. Supporters of the reclassification have argued the move would give local officials more direct control of programs and would bring better opportunities to the city. But some are worried the hyper-urbanization would lead to higher taxes and loss of support and benefits from the provincial government. San Jose del Monte is the largest city in Bulacan and had met the minimum requirements to be classified as a highly urbanized city, which would have given it autonomy from the provincial government. You only die once. That reminder from insurance company Sun Life. Its cluster head, Ryan Anthony C., said Filipinos tend to live in the present rather than in the future. That's why life insurance premiums are not in their priorities. He adds Filipinos can actually afford life insurance, but some are more inclined to prioritize tangible things that they can use in the present.
Life insurance is not for us. It's because that we love somebody else. For example, today we're commemorating and remembering the people that we love. We always want to remember them with fond memories. If without life insurance, kadalasan ang naiwan po doon ay utang. We want to leave the family with good memories, with money instead of debt.